had attempted to make a statement on society, but was yanked after a wave of online criticism.
These days, more and more brands are feeling pressure to take a stand, whether it is pulling ads from controversial media outlets or weighing in on politics. But there is a risk in doing both. They could be alienating some of their customers. For more, we're joined by Janine Poggi, media reporter for Advertising Age. Good morning.
Good morning.
So we live in a highly charged political climate. Is it just inevitable that brands have to choose which side of the aisle they want to stand on?
I don't think it's inevitable. I think that there are ways to avoid getting involved in the conversation. If you really don't want to be involved in the political conversation, you obviously don't make a commercial like Pepsi did. But I think it's become more of a pull for advertisers to make a stand. Social media, of course, has made it really important for brands to have a voice. And consumers want to hear what their favorite brands are saying on topics they care about.
I've heard from CEOs in some companies that millennial customers particularly want some kind of commitment from the company that they're buying from. Is that playing into this too?
They want to know that the brand that they're buying from understands them, understands what they think of the world and relates to them as a consumer. And I do think that that's playing a part in this.
So is the sort of political stand driven actually by market research? I mean, this is just about targeting customers, is it not?
I think it's just about being in the zeitgeist. You know, they want to
be
relevant. They want to be talked about. They want to be in conversations that are, you know, filled with fervor and people are talking about, and they want to be in there. So I think if you look at Pepsi's commercial,
But that was bad talking about, was it?
It was.
And they didn't want to be talked about like that.
It was tone deaf. You know, they wanted to be talked about as being part of the conversation about protests and about, you know, understanding this type of topic. It obviously completely missed the mark and was incredibly tone deaf. But that's what they were aiming for.
Right. So how has this affected the content and the placement of advertising?
Yeah, I think that's just as important. It's not just the creative anymore. It's where ads are running. We see with Breitbart all of the advertisers that have pulled out from there because of all of the noise on social media and, you know, consumers saying, we don't want to see your ads on places that are not trustworthy. We see with Google and YouTube how ads were appearing in some, you know, terrorist-backed content. Many advertisers pulled off of YouTube. And then you see with Bill O'Reilly and his show how advertisers are reacting, more than 50 advertisers pulling out of the show in response to the allegations made against him. So I think it's really important right now that it's not just about creative, but also where you're running your ads.
We saw this week how social media can absolutely damage a brand. The United Airlines video that went viral, exchanged hundreds of millions of times around the world. In terms of social media and viral video, do brands have infrastructure? Do they have people on staff that understand social media in the way that they need to in the 21st century?
They say they do. They definitely have. You know, you see many brands have war rooms and have people who are just in charge of their social media. But a lot of times, you know, it's quick thinking. A lot of quick reaction that's needed. I think Skittles was probably one of the best ones to do a reaction when Donald Trump, you know, made comments about refugees and comparing them to Skittles. And I think that they did the right thing because they came out and they said, you know, refugees are people, Skittles are candy, that's it. We're not making any other statement on this because we don't want to appear as though we're using this as a marketing opportunity. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what's important to remember. This is real life situations. You know, these are not marketing opportunities. And I think when brands use them as such, that's when they really get into trouble.
All right, Janine Poggi, thanks very much for being with us this morning.